Trivia number one from YouTube. What is the most viewed YouTube video of all time? Do you know this?
This one's gonna be...
Yes, congratulations, all right, we got it. Has 12.3 billion views.
My kids have contributed a significant fraction to that.
They watched it a couple of hundred times. All right, the third one. What is the first video to reach a million views on YouTube?
Oh, what is this?
Welcome back to the Taipei Tonight Show. We have our special guest, Steve Chen, with us here today. Thank you again for being here. I'm so excited to have you. And indeed, to hear the stories, they're just so interesting. And we're talking during the break, it's quite inspiring to maybe the young entrepreneurs or who are thinking about being entrepreneurs out there, that maybe some of the ideas can start quite simply.
Yeah,
it could be a very simple idea. Don't overthink and not being able to take a first step at any point.
Exactly. I think if anything, the advice is just take on that bit of risk before having to figure out whether or not everything is risk-free. Mm-hmm. So I think all startups, they all have to go through like what YouTube has done, going from a dating service to a general video service.
Yeah.
But if we didn't take that initial step, we wouldn't have known what YouTube could be.
Yeah. Did you ever assume or foresee YouTube being what it is today?
Now, when you're starting a company in Silicon Valley, you don't think, something's going to be, it's the number one downloaded app right now on the iPhone. And I even remember I was in my 20s at the time. This was before getting married, before having kids. But years later, when my older son, he was holding an iPhone in his hand and he was watching, like many kids do, he was using YouTube and watching YouTube videos. And this is the first time I revealed to him that,
I had something to do with that.
Do you know who's behind this? And then he had no idea what I was talking about.
How did he react?
Well, he was astonished for a sec, and then he looked at me and was like, well, Daddy, how are you such a good actor to be behind every single one of these videos? So he thought what I meant was...
You made...
Every
All
single
those
video, like I'm the person in every video. I don't think the kids understood that there's a whole team. There's the whole team behind this search engine. There's a whole team that's building what's behind YouTube. But after he came to that realization, I think he appreciated it more.
Oh, wow. Okay. Yeah. So I mean, it must be just mind blowing. I mean, for your kids to even wrap their heads around. My dad created YouTube. He was one of the people that was responsible for this thing that changed really the landscape of
I have to confess, I think even years ago, it had already surpassed any of my expectations, right? I mean, I think that, again, going back to this sort of new generation, many of them, they see their career path, their ideal career is to become a YouTuber, is to be able to create content that they're passionate about and being able to generate an entire living out of doing what they really truly enjoy. And so I think that fact has really transformed my thinking about what we created as a dating service for videos. It's not just evolved into something that's more general types of content, but it's almost changed the thinking and the ideology of what we want to do when we grow up is actually just be on this platform and create content that we enjoy, we like.
Yeah, and the possibilities are literally endless because you literally cannot imagine what kind of seed you plant today, what might come of it one day. It could take on a life of its own and grow into something, right? So how does YouTube, how much does it play in your life, in your kids' life?
I have the privilege not many parents have, which is to be able to tell the kids, stop using daddy's app at 8 p.m. I don't have to tell them to stop using YouTube. I also have the privilege of telling them, don't download TikTok, just keep using YouTube. But it's fascinating because I think you, me, and the family, we all kind of download and use the app. It's the most frequently downloaded, most frequently used app, but we use it for very different types of content, right? But I think that it goes to say, I think it has become sort of the like the sea of content for the internet. It's come sort of synonymous with, if you want to find a video, you search for it on YouTube. And right now, we all know the most popular, most visited search engine out there is Google's number one. But I think it's a surprise to many people that the number two search engine out there is YouTube. You know, yes. Like the most frequently used place to listen to music is actually not, you know, Spotify or Apple Music, but it's actually YouTube. Yeah. So it's a surprise that YouTube has been able to kind of fulfill many different types of needs from different users around the world.
It changed. It came up. It has its own terminology now. The YouTuber. nobody knew what that was. And then it changed. It changed my line of work. Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm a TV personality. I do TV shows. I do radio shows. And I remember there was one day that it dawned on me that the catchphrase that I use every single day is, you know, don't forget to tune in tomorrow at the same time at the same channel is no longer valid, because YouTube has just made everything available, everything everywhere all at once. It's always there now, right? It's changed everything. So what are the hobbies of the co-founder of YouTube? I mean, what do you do?
So a lot of stuff with, for example, cameras and photography. And before, I was always searching up on this. But once you start getting into this, or I love headphones. And once you start getting into these videos often have, they're not millions of views. They have a few hundred thousand views. But it's all people that are into cameras, into digital cameras, into headphones. They end up converging on watching this video, and then you read the comments, and it's basically the internet coming together and meeting at a video. Yeah. And this is where they interact, and this is where they share their passions and talk about things.
And a spinoff to the subject is you meet these people that are also interested in it, in the comments and the conversations that you have following it. That's also another thing that's kind of like a life of its own. Right?
Exactly. Yeah.
And musicians, you guys must be on YouTube all the time.
Oh, definitely.
Right? For the mud wrestling or for the I mean, even as pros, do you guys use it?
Well, of course, I'm in to see live concerts and to check out other musicians. Right. You know, a lot of people go on there for KTV.
Yes. So for live concerts, I mean, that's such a blessing. It was rare to find, for instance, back in the days, to find a record, to own a record, or who had which one. Wow, to hear that sound, you needed to that physical thing. Or for the concerts, there were some iconic concerts that if you had access to that DVD, that was precious. Now you can find it, and you can locate it, and you can watch it anytime you want.
And I think it's from a creator standpoint, one unique point about YouTube is that it has this revenue sharing program in there. And so if you're creating content, if you're creating music and people are listening to your music, for every time that somebody's listening to your music, you actually get a portion of the revenue that's generated by YouTube. So being a YouTuber is not just becoming sort of an iconic, famous figure, but you can actually, it can actually generate revenue for you and your team.
All right, sounds like we have the co-founder of YouTube here, and he's still definitely the expert of YouTube. So we have a couple of YouTube trivia questions. See if you can help us with. Trivia number one from YouTube. What is the most viewed YouTube video of all time? Do you know this?
This one's gonna be Baby Shark. And I think my kids have contributed a significant fraction to that.
I've watched it a couple of hundred times. Is it Baby Shark? Yes, congratulations. All right, we got it. We got Baby Shark has 12.3 billion views. Baby Shark.
Mysteriously addictive for all kids. Okay. They could just watch it over and over and over again. It's just very easy to be able to understand, regardless of, you know, regardless of language, regardless, it's just appealing content.
All right, I gotta look that up. All right, number two. That's what do you have? What is the longest video ever on YouTube? Do you know this one?
No, I mean, because when I was still there, we had a limit of 30 minutes. I'm sure it's going to be much longer than that.
It used to be a limit of 30 minutes.
Because I had to pay for the storage for how much the videos we were taking in.
Okay.
Yeah, there we go.
Okay. Yeah. All right. All right. So no longer.
Longer than 30 minutes.
No longer. Right? All right. So the longest video on YouTube currently is made by someone named Jonathan Harchik. Photos of a trip to Chile. Not sure if it's still there, but it was on there, and it held the record for 571 hours. All right, the third one. What is the first video to reach a million views on YouTube?
Oh, what is this? Either I think a Nike Ronaldinho video, there's a Saturday Night Live video. Those are my guesses.
Pretty good. It's a Nike video featuring Ronaldo in 2005. The first video ever to hit a million views.
Nike invited us up. There's a whole story behind it. They uploaded this video under an artificial name called Joe B. So you would never know that this was Nike's marketing department.
Okay.
And then they would surprise them with how many videos it received, but it was actually created by Nike themselves. But after they saw that received a million views, they invited us to go up to Nike. And it just goes to kind of show the kind of foresight of Nike's marketing department to try out new methods of being able to market their materials. And so we talked to them about, what are the different ways that you could upload this content?
Yeah.
And then they finally ended up uploading another piece of content under the Nike name instead of Joe B. I think that they were one of the very, very first early adopters of viral video marketing.
Because what is going to come out of it? So that's why they use different names and just to try out the water.
I think they didn't tell their legal department, because we ended up getting a lawsuit filed against YouTube from their legal department that said, can you give us the IP address? Where was this uploaded
from? Who's doing this?
And we tracked it back. And we're like, this is coming from your office. They said, OK, well, let's go talk to the marketing department to see if they uploaded this piece of content.
That is so interesting. Wow. All right, one more, all right. What year did the Vatican launch their YouTube channel? The Vatican has their YouTube channel.
I was still there.
You were there?
I was still at YouTube at the time. It was like 2008, 2009. It was pretty early that they adopted YouTube, I think.
That's really pretty good. 2009 is the correct answer. That's pretty good. You do know your YouTube. That's pretty amazing. We have more coming your way. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.